Hello, everyone, and welcome to the third bonus episode of Let's Play Kingdom Hearts Final Mix HD for the PC. As per usual with bonus episodes, I am Nomadic Arc, and I'll be the only one on this one for the commentary. And we have a couple of things to show off today in this bonus episode. First on the agenda is special cutscenes that you get in Monstro if you've defeated the first Riku fight in Hollow Bastion. Second off would be the correct voiced dialogue cutscene for winning the Hercules Cup. Third would be the white and yellow trinities that we haven't collected yet. And then fourth would be the Final Mix exclusive Heartless that I haven't shown off yet. Those being the Sniper Wild, the Pink Agaricus, and that should be about it. If we get a time in the bonus here in the bonus episode, I will also show off the Stealth Soldier in Hollow Bastion, but I cannot guarantee that because I do not want this episode to run overly long, as it is just a bonus episode. Anyways, let's jump right into it. Starting with the Monstro stuff. Now, here at the beginning, I'm just going to go at normal speed for collecting the cutscenes here. And really, the only fight we're going to actually fight is Parasite Cage 1, because we're just showing off cutscenes here. So, let's go.
What are you doing? Come on, let's go back.
You know, Geppetto's awfully worried about you.
Pinocchio, stop fooling around. This is no time for games.
But Sora, I thought you liked games. Or are you too cool to play them now that you have the Keyblade?
Riku, is it really you?
Now, take note of the fact that Sora was a little surprised, it sounded, and in disbelief that Riku was here, because, of course, we just defeated him at Hollow Bastion. So, he shouldn't be here, or at least we defeated him at least once. Now, while I'll be running away, I can't really control what Donald and Goofy do, so I'll keep running while they do whatever. Now, take notice that in the cutscene that just went by, we didn't have it. In the original version, there, right prior to this one, Maleficent. There was a cutscene with Maleficent and Riku where she chided him for messing with Sora. And he's like, I was just messing with him, I was just having a little bit of fun. And then she's like, you really shouldn't be doing that, you should be watching yourself, because you're getting prideful. And also, Sora confronted Riku in this very room. None of that happened, and it's just one of the many changes.
See ya!
Yeah, we're just gonna use the easy way out to get rid of Parasite Cage. Nice and easy. Another difference you'll notice is that right prior to the fight with Parasite Cage in the original, Riku asked Sora if he was ready to help him defeat the Parasite Cage, and Sora was like, "Yeah, let's do it." And then I don't know if actually Riku actually helps you or not, but regardless, that didn't happen either.
Pinocchio! Pinocchio! Please, give me back my son!
Yet another change, right here. In the original version, Riku had a conversation with Geppetto, telling him, yeah, it is strange that Pinocchio does seem a little strange. Not many puppets have hearts. Maybe he can help someone who's lost theirs. Sora questions if that he's talking about Riku. Riku ignores him and walks off. Now, yes, you will notice that I have Mermaid Kick here with Glide before High Jump, and that's because like I said before, I completely skipped Monstro in this save file in order to make it so that I could show off these cutscenes. And yes, it was hard to defeat Giant Ursula at level 32, which is what level I was at. Also, Shadow Sora on Hook in Neverland was really hard as well. Like, I think Giant Ursula took like about, I would say 30 tries. Shadow Sora took 20.
What? You don't remember your best friend?
Liar! You're not Riku!
Pinocchio! Pinocchio!
Kimmy, I'm not gonna make it.
Oh!
I guess I'm okay!
That's all the cutscenes. Cutscene changes. The rest of it is just as normal. Other than the fact that Sora doesn't exclaim "Riku!" after you defeated the Parasite Cage when everything's crumbling around him. Now, let's jump into the second item on our agenda. And that would be going to the Colosseum here on save slot 4. Now here we have defeated we have defeated the Phil and Pegasus Cups, and we're about ready to fight the Hercules Cups. If you recall, it was either episode 10 or 11 that we did the Hercules Cup right at the end. Problem is, it fired a cutscene that was kind of messed up because there's supposed to be a voice dialogue cutscene that fires right after you win the Hercules Cup, but it was unvoiced, just text. So that was a screw up that happens because I didn't defeat the Phil and Pegasus Cups before I completed the Hercules Cup. The game really expects you to do them in order. Also, if you defeat the Hercules Cup before the Phil and Pegasus Cups, you will not get your reward you're supposed to get, which I will explain once we complete the Hercules Cup. Also, since we have actually seen the Hercules Cup's fights, I will be going ahead and speeding up that footage so you don't have to waste time with it, so we don't waste time with it. So, let's go ahead and jump right into it.
Thank you.
Alright, and we're back. So let's see that cutscene. And the rewards we're supposed to get.
We're the champs!
Urk's shield, which we didn't get before.
Wow! And I didn't even hold back!
Now I finally know what you mean about strength of heart. Mine comes from Donald and Goofy.
Come again?
If we stick together, we're unbeatable. Not even Hercules stands a chance. With these guys beside me, I'm ready for anything.
But that's not exactly
what... Of course. Your friends give you strength. Isn't that right, Phil? The three of you together make great heroes. And as a team, I'm sure you can overcome anything.
We also got the Olympia, a Keyblade we did get before. And we learned Yellow Trinity. Olympia isn't great. I mean, it's pretty good for strength and whatnot, but not for... We're not using it because we are mage. We are mage. That's all we are. Anyways, first Yellow Trinity. Seen this cutscene, though. It's just us locking Olympus. Alright, so now that we've locked that, let's begin our hunt for Trinities and whatnot. Now, we do have to get everything here in Olympus because we haven't actually gotten anything yet. First thing, Violetta for Donald. Great if you're wanting Donald to hit things hard, but he's a mage. He shouldn't be hitting things. Oh crap, that's wrong magic!
Deep freeze!
There we go, that's better.
Deep freeze! Deep freeze! Deep freeze!
There's also another treasure you can get from putting out the braziers here with Blizzaga instead of Blizzara, but we don't have that, so we'll get it later. Now, On to our first Trinity. We're going to start at the back and work our way forward because with that, we can get the Funmix exclusive Heartless I haven't shown off along with the Trinities when we hit them. Anyway, and besides, there's a spell here we get with the Yellow Trinity here in Neverland that's really helpful. Starting here at the ship, hold, because the Yellow Trinity is, like, right here. Now we have Arrow Ra. Very useful. Honestly, I was just trying to run him off so he could get this.
I'm
Okay, that yellow trinity there is kind of pointless. I'll show you why. What it does is put that pedestal there so you can jump up and get into there, but see, you can get there easily with high jump. High jump. Yeah, sorry, do the thing. With high jump, you can, from the steps, you can high jump over, ledge grab, and pull yourself up. Or if you happen to skip Monstro and go straight to Atlantica and Atlantica Halloween Town in Neverland, you can glide. You can glide over here. Let me show that without high jump. As you can see, yeah, you can glitch. You can glide from the from. Like, right where it's, the text for the next room pops up. And, bam, do the same thing. So it's very, that yellow trinity is kind of, how shall we say, pointless? Alright, breaking in here to explain what we're about to do. I got really lucky because the white shroom spawned on first entry. So, we're about to do the pink agaricus fight, which is actually kind of easy. How you'll know it's time for the pink agaricus? The white mushrooms will show up and they will be very evident in the fact that they are only doing the stomp move. So, you walk up to them, stomp them! They're happy, they toss some MP orbs your way. And I'm wishing I had a... Oh, there we go. Really won't need that. Treasure magnet will be a little more useful. Yep. He could be right there, or I think he's actually up. I think he's up there. Ding! Looks like it. Where is he? Up down there. Oh, there he is. Okay.
Stop.
All right, we've stuffed all three of them. Now, the pink agaricus mushroom is inside the treehouse. Now, what we want to do is get Goofy and Donald over here. Let's summon some Bambi. Now, because we see them, they can't transport beside me and thus interrupt what we're about to do, because if Donald and Goofy attack the pink agaricus, he goes away. We only want Sora to attack him. So our first step... our first step is... stop!
Here! Wind! Power! Come on!
We only got 51 hits, but if you get to around 100, you can get the, let's see, it says here you can get the Prime Cap, which is an armor, or an accessory, I'm sorry, because there's no armor in this game. But you can also get the Serenity Power, which is a synthesis item you'll need several of, and the Mystery Goo. Now, off to the White Trinity. Oh, good. No Heartless spawning here means that we've got the Heartless we want to run into here. The Funimation exclusive Heartless known as the Sniper Wild, which The way he works is, he'll first show up as one. If you defeat the if you defeat him, you get some HP orbs. That's what you get, HP orbs for the the first through fifth Sniper Wilds. The sixth one gives you HP orbs, some money orbs, 100% chance of a potion, and a 35% chance of a Power Stone. The Power Stone is the synthesis item that you want to get from him. And basically, you, your prizes go up from there depending on how many Sniper Wilds you defeat, up to the 30th, at which point it restarts. It just restarts the entire setup again. With the 30th Sniper Wild, you get money, 100% chance at one Power Stone, and 100% chance of a drop of a second Power Stone. Anyways, let's see. We have Stopra and Aurora. Perfect. We need the same setup for Sniper Wild that we need for Pink Agaricus. Let's see if we can get the Power Stone off of this guy. Where is he? Okay, there he is. Initially, the Sniper Wild will be fairly carefree, not caring about where he's jumping around to. He's not all that cautious, he doesn't care. He will stop to look around a little bit every so often. See, now they're already starting to be slightly more cautious. Ever so slightly more cautious. Not jumping around as much. Watching their back a little more.
Stop! Come on!
Might also help if I throw. Ripple Drive back on. Now, the game will only go bad if you feel that Sora gets seen by the Sniper Wild. If they see, they can see Donald and Goofy all they want. It doesn't matter because the game's a little nice about that. Also, the game's also a little nice about the fact that you don't stay in battle mode the entire time, and you can go back to the menu if you need to after you kill one of them, so you can restore your MP with cottages and whatnot. Because even Goofy can't keep doing MP gift forever. When he's not taking damage or doing damage. That was kind of close. Okay, we've lost. But yeah, you see how it goes. You keep getting... You keep defeating them until you get, like, around... At minimum, probably you'll need to get to 6 of them. But your best bet at getting Power Stones is defeating, like, at least 12. Which is easier once you have Stop-Ga. And are a little... and have a... like around, probably around 13 MP. Anyways, let's see, we've got the final navigation gummy. I suggest we go to straight to, get Sid to install that sucker and go straight to Hollow Bastion to get the rest of those treasure chests, and, that's where we'll end off. I'll see you at the next treasure chest. Speeding up now. Okay, right there! There's our final Final Mix exclusive Heartless for the episode. That right there with the cursed heretical on it is known as the Stealth Soldier. He is a bastard. You can't see him until you've just hurt him enough. And as you can see, he has a decent chunk of HP, and he hits like a freight train. I think that was him hitting me. That's what he looks like. Damn it, he's sure in the way. I can't see shit. He drops energy stones. Another Final Mix exclusive, since this material you'll need. Alright, now that we've seen that, now we can skip. I'm glad he actually showed up right there. Because now we can skip the rest of the fights and go for treasure.
Yeah. Oh,
complete this side quest. That we're gonna head to a safe point, and that's where we're gonna call it for this bonus episode. Looks like I've got me some editing to do. The raw length is around nearly 2 hours. Most of that because of Hollow Bastion, of course. But let's see what doing 500 times speed, 500% speed does to several sections. Anyways, I want to thank all you guys for watching. We'll be back with episode 12 later on. See you then.